Hey guys, welcome. Today we have a relatively easy problem. It is called building roads. Byteland has M cities and M roads between them. The goal is to construct new roads so that there is a route between any two cities. Now your task is to find out the minimum number of roads required and also determine which roads should be built. So they give an example and the output. Basically, you're given n, the number of cities. Then you're given m, the number of roads already in existence. So we have one connected to two, three connected to four. This problem is all about finding connected components, and you can do that with depth first search easily. I'm going to show you how, but first let's take a look at this example. So you have city one connected to city two, and also you have city three connected to city 4. Remember, your n is 4. Now you're told to build a road, the minimum number of roads, so that you can visit basically any city from any city. So right now you can only go from 1 to 2 and vice versa, and you can only go from 3 to 4. So there's no way to get from 1 to 4, for example. So if we are to add a road like this, that should solve our problem. Or we could add something like this, or we could add a route like this. All of that is quite valid. So how do we approach this? First, notice that we basically have two distinct connected components, and we just need a single road to join them. And we are good. Okay, you could have a different example, like let's see, so in this case you have three connected components and you're going to need two distinct roads to make everything connected. All right, so you have those three right here. And you can have maybe one or two roads to get them done. All right, so how do you approach this? The first thing we're going to do is loop through each city. So let me show you what that looks like. So we're going to loop through each city. And first of all, we're going to run depth first search, let me write that down, on the very first node to discover any city connected to it. Once we've done that, then we can loop through the rest of the cities. And whenever we get to a node that is yet to be visited, we can simply connect that node to the very first node one. Okay? And once you've done that, you can then run the first search on that particular node to discover any city connected to it. So we're going to see this with an example. But basically, the idea is to just find the connected components, and that's it. So let's see. Let's quickly see what that looks like. So we first run our depth first search here, and that should find two. Okay. We look through. We come to three. We are yet to visit three. So we just put that in an array for now. And then we're going to run that first search on this to find the number four. And that's it. Once you come to four, you've already visited four. So you're done. Now you have this number three. All you need to do is connect it to one. Okay. So first thing we're going to print is the size of this array. And then you're just going to connect every item in that array with one. And you're good. So this is our answer. and it's quite similar to the output, this is still a valid answer. Let's see how that works with this example. So we first run our depth first search here, and that should find 2 and 3. Okay, we continue our loop. Here we visited 2, we visited 3. We come to 4. We are here to visit 4. So let's put that in an array. All right, we're going to connect that to one letter. And then we're going to run depth first search on 4, and it's going to find 6 and 5. All right, so we come to 5, we visited 5, we visited 6, come to 7, we're here to visit it. So we add that 7 to our array and run depth first search, which would find 8. So we're done with 7 and we're done with 8. At the end of this, we're just going to print the size of this array, which is 2. Then we're going to connect each of those numbers in the array to 1. So we have 1, 4, 1, 7. And this, my friends, would also be a valid answer for this particular example. So that's the way it works. The time complexity of this is going to be bigger of n time, because we're going to process each node at most once. The space is also going to be bigger of n, since we are going to maintain a visited array to make sure we don't process a node more than once. So that's it. You should pause the video at this point and try the implementation on your own. We're going to do that next. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is to read in the input. We are going to solve the problem. So we have our n and n. Then we're going to read in an adjacency list. All right, so we have that. Let's create a class to solve this. Let's call it building roads. Okay, like I said, let's have an array of visited nodes, which would help us avoid processing a node more than once. So this should receive n and the adjacency list passed in as a reference. Okay. Let us initialize our visited node with n items. Next, we're going to have the list I mentioned, which would contain the nodes you're going to connect to the very first node when you're done processing every node. So like I said, we're going to run DFS on the first number. Let me just define that. We're going to need this. So this is a very simple function. If you've seen a node before, you just return. Otherwise, mark it as visited and run DFS on the children. So for That's it. Very straightforward. All right, so once we have that function, and we have run DFS on the first node, let's run for the rest of the nodes. So we can start from 2, we've already processed 1, and go all the way to n. So if we're yet to visit a node, then we're going to add it to nodes to be connected, and then we're going to run DFS on it. All right, so once we're done, we're going to build the result by connect. Connecting the nodes to be connected to 1. All right. So we're to print the number of roads, and then the roads themselves. So like I said, you connect each of them to 1. And that's it. Once you're done, you return the result, which we're going to print out here. All right, let us try this out with the example they gave. And we have 1, 1, 3. Just like we expected. Okay. I think that's it. I'm going to try to submit this. It's a pretty straightforward question. All right, fantastic. This got accepted. Thanks for watching.